In today's video, we're going to talk about Cypress automation testing, and we're going to talk about working with dynamic content and wait strategies. So, in web applications, elements or data may load dynamically due to asynchronous processes like API calls, animations, or lazy loading. Cypress offers several wait strategies and commands to handle these scenarios effectively, ensuring the tests are reliable and not flaky. So first, there's Cypress's built-in tree try mechanism. Cypress automatically retries commands and assertions until the element becomes available or the default timeout is reached, and the default is 4 seconds. This behavior reduces the need for manual waits. For example, in this command, it'll try as many times as it needs to until this dynamic element command becomes available, or it'll try until 4 seconds, and then if it's not available, then it'll continue. You can also use Cypress wait, and sometimes you need to pause an execution to wait for asynchronous operations like API responses or animations. And so you can use Cypress wait to cautiously avoid flaky tests. And so in this command, this is in milliseconds. So this is actually waiting for 2 seconds. You can also wait for specific elements. So instead of waiting for a fixed time, it's better to wait for elements to be visible or exist in the DOM using should. And so right here, if we use the get loader, then we use .should to see if it not exists or exists. And down here, we're doing the same thing, but to see if it's visible. You can also polling elements with the then command. Use the .then method to check dynamic content inside callbacks, which ensures that assertions only run when elements are ready. And you can do that using this command here. You can also use Cypress wait until for custom polling. Install the Cypress wait until plugin to handle complex wait scenarios. And this is an example of that. You can also handle delayed animations and transitions. So web element animations or CSS transitions can delay element appearance. So use the cy.wait cautiously to ensure the animation completes, or use should assertion with timeouts. You can also handle lazy loading or infinite scroll content. For content that loads as you scroll, use cy.scrollTo to trigger the loading. For example, right here, to trigger lazy loading with scroll, you use scroll to the bottom to get all of the content within the page. You can also look at increasing default timeouts for slow content. So you can extend the command timeout if the content loads slowly due to network delays. And so an example of increasing the command timeout for one command, you can use this command right here by adding timeout 10 seconds right here. And then you can also globally increase the timeouts by configuring in your cypress.config file. And this is the command that you would use. You would set the default command timeout to 10 seconds instead. So the best practices for wait strategies. So prefer to built-in retries. You should use should and get to wait for elements and avoid cypress.wait as much as possible. You should use API stubbing with cy.intercept, and this ensures predictable behavior for dynamic data. You should increase timeouts only when necessary. Use custom timeouts for slow loading elements instead of arbitrary waits. And you should handle flaky tests. Identify flaky elements and adjust your wait strategy to reduce failures. In this next part of the video, we're going to show you how you can code this in your own project. So right here, I have a project open, and I'm actually going to create a new script for interacting for these different wait statements. So I'm going to go here, and I'm going to create a new file, and I'm going to name it wait.cs.cy.js. And within this file, we're going to do a few things. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to require Cypress XPath. And then what we're going to do after is we're going to use describe. We're going to use Cypress test. And after that, we're going to use our first test. And we're going to call it cy.get default wait for 4 seconds. So we're just going to show you how it's typically done. So this one, you're not hard coding any waits, and we're just going to use the default for Cypress which waits 4 seconds for element to appear. And so I'm going to, first, I'm going to type this uncaught exception. And this basically just lets our code proceed even if there's any errors. And so go ahead and do this. Oops, actually, this will be false. And then after that, I'm going to visit our base URL using this. And then after that, I'm going to do contains test. And what we're going to do is we're going to click on that. And then we're going to do contains. We're going to find the web elements page. Let's type that as web elements. And then we're going to click that as well, but we're going to use force is equal to true. And so after that, now what we're going to do is we're going to get this button. So button one is what it's called. And we're going to say that it should be visible. So we're going to check that it's visible. And then if it is, then we'll click it. So this is by default. This is what it does. This waits 4 seconds by default. And so go ahead and save that. And now let me show you what it looks like. So I'm going to go ahead and type X Cypress open and see if we run it and see what happens. D2E testing. I'm going to run it in Chrome. And right here we have the wait. So I'm going to open up that script. And then right here, this is what we have. So first what we did was we visited our base URL, which we set as admlucid.com. We found tests, we clicked that. And then we found web elements to click that. And then that brought us to a new page. In this new page, we found the button. And this button was available after multiple tries within 4 seconds. And then we asserted that it is visible and then we clicked it. So that's the first way you can do it. There are some other ways you can use wait statements. So this one, we didn't explicitly say any wait statements, but there are some other ones you can do. So for example, in this one, I'm basically doing the same thing, but I'm going to the same page and then I'm explicitly saying, let's wait 2 seconds. And then what we'll do is we'll get these each of these text elements as well. And then we'll clear this text box and then type in this. And then we'll assert that this is typed into this text field. So that's what we're doing for that one. And then let me show you some other ones we can do. So in this one, basically what we're doing is we're going to the same page. And then this one, we're not actually doing any explicit waiting. And so what we're doing is we're going to that page and we're just seeing if each of these are visible and we're just using the should statement. So we're not saying, we're not using the wait statement, but instead we're saying that let's try to get this. And if it's not available, then we use the assert that it's not visible. And then this will cause a breakage in our code so that we can fix that later. And then we'll check that afterwards. And so instead of using explicit waits, we're using should instead to validate the state of each character. Now, the next thing what we'll do is we'll show you another way we can do this. And this one is basically setting the timeout, setting the default, changing the timeout. So in here, we go to this golf course page instead, but this time in this get statement, we're setting the timeout as 10 seconds instead of 4 seconds, which is the default, universal default in general. And so these four tests, let me show you how it goes. So this one, we're explicitly saying wait 2 seconds extra. We load this page and then we wait 2 seconds and then we get text field one, type welcome to Cypress test, and then we'll assert that this is within here. In this one, we're navigating to web elements right here, and then we're clicking. And then what we're doing is we're finding the text boxes using should statements. So we found that this text box is visible. Then this allows us to check it. And then we're doing the same thing for the other ones as well. For this one, we're setting the default wait time by 10 seconds instead of 4 seconds. And so this get statement, when we get the select, it'll actually try it for 10 seconds and see if it can get the select. And if it can, then we'll basically select Mexico within it and then assert that Mexico is selected. And so this is some of the easiest ways that you can use wait statements with Cypress. If you found this video helpful, please give this video a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for listening.